let's make our Python script something actually useful. So let's change calc again. If we're not printing 1 plus 1 anymore, but printing the evaluated. So this here asks me to input something. This here evaluates it. So if I type something to calculate, it will evaluate it. If I type 1 plus 1, it will evaluate it, returning 2. And this here prints it. Okay, so if I now run dot slash calc, I can calculate 1 plus 1 divided by 2 something, which will calculate the actual result. So yeah, we finally have something useful. Okay. So if I want here, which Python, like I said, it knows where to find Python. It only knows where to find Python because there's a variable of folders in which to look for binaries. This variable is called the path variable. And only if an executable is in a folder that's in that path variable, only then I can type then simply the name of the command without specifying a path. So if I want to run the git command, the binary for git must be in my path variable. Now, for some of you guys, for example, the git commands didn't work on the terminal. That's because you didn't have git in your path, the git folder in your path variable. Or same thing for the conda command. So the difference between the normal terminal and the git bash, or between the normal terminal and the anaconda prompt, is simply that the git bash has all git commands added to the path inside this shell, and the anaconda prompt had the same for any conda command. So you could run git without having in your path from, you can run git without having in your path from your git bash. You can, however, manually add it to your path, which we'll do in a second. Okay, so let's look at this variable. The command echo in bash means the same as print in Python, so it just prints something. Dollar in bash stands for a variable, so every variable must start with a dollar, and the path variable is called dollar path. And now dollar path contains a bunch of folders separated by colons. These are the folders in which bash will look for binaries when I type in the name of a command. Okay, on Windows, the variable would be called %path%. And you can't edit, while you can echo it just like that in Windows, you can't edit it on the terminal in Windows. You need to look for the system variables and then simply add it, add something to the system variable path. I made another video about that. Okay, so now if I want to add something to my path, I can use the syntax export path equals and then my path, so in this case, what about this directory, and then colon, and then the rest of path. Note that if binaries are in multiple of the paths in the path variable, it will start with the first one. So if you want to make sure that a program that is in a certain folder is executed like that program. So if the same binary exists, for example, in this and in this folder, then it will take the one which is listed first. So from there. So if you want to make sure that the program in the folder you want to have it is taken, that folder must be the first one. So now we exported our path variable to be tilde and then path. So if we now look at path again, the first one is now our home directory. As we said, tilde is our home directory. So now I can use the calc command without specifying a path. And I can do it from everywhere. So if I now change to another folder, I can still run the calculate command. So that's a really, really useful thing. However, as soon as we restart this terminal, the path variable would be reset to its original state. So this only works here locally. Now you may be wondering why in the lecture I sometimes use the command change conda, and the reason is simple. So if we look at the path variable now, if I now source change conda and look at the path variable again, what my change conda simply does, it either prepends or removes my miniconda binary path to the path variable. So what the command source change conda does, so I created a binary change conda, I added it to my path, or rather I moved it in a folder which is looked anyway. I think it's slash home, user local bin, which simply prepends that using the language bash. And then the command source simply treats a file as if every single line would be typed into the shell itself. So normally when you'd have a shell file, you couldn't export variables in there, but when you source them, it treats the shell file, it treats individual lines as if it would be typed into the shell itself. So if I source change conda, it simply eventually reads the line export path equals, and then the miniconda path colon dollar path. Okay, note that path being an environment variable, you can also look at the contents of that in Python. In Python, you'd have to import OS, and then you can call os.envir1, and then the name of the variable, this path. So you could even use Python to look at and change your variables. Okay. So now, if you want to add your own fancy commands, what you can either do is you can use your path variable, you can change your path variable to include the path where your fancy commands are, or what you can alternatively do is you could make a symbolic link from your file in a folder which is actually looked at by the path variable standardly. So let's remove this one, because I think that leads to bad side effects if I leave my home directory in the path. So now we set it to its original state, but I can symbolic link my my newly created calc. To do so, I need to write with the super user do command, and for that I just removed my screen capture here. Okay, so to do that, I need to ln minus s, which creates a symbolic link to this folder. This must be the absolute folder. And then the binary calc into, let's say, slash user slash bin. Oh yeah, I need to do that as super user. Okay, so if I now run calc, I can use it everywhere. Okay, if I look at the contents of that, so what is now slash user slash bin slash calc, and I can use less minus la user slash bin slash calc, should tell me it's a symbolic link pointing to slash home slash gis slash calc. So now I can run from any terminal window, I can simply run calc, and then I can type whatever I want to calculate. So now I've added my own fancy command to my Unix environment. I can do that for much more complex programs than this one. Okay. If you want, however, so now you could simply ln minus s your git binaries, for example, into a folder that's in the path variable. But if you want to don't want to add every single binary there, what you can also do is you can make your operating system, at least for the Unix based ones, you can simply put it somewhere such that it will, every time the computer starts, it will do exactly what you did here, and that is export it, export your path to include, so change your path variable to include that path too. On Windows, if you did the what I showed in the video, you will edit permanently anyway. Okay, so what happens on Unix-based systems is when the computer starts, it will source, so interpret line by line as if it was typed directly into the terminal, certain files. For example, this .bashrc, it's in your home directory. Everything you type in the .bashrc will be sourced when you start the computer. So if you type in your bashrc export path equals, and then let's say your git is in /etc/git and then $path, and now if I save that, as soon as I restart my computer, it will, first thing it will do, it will source this .bashrc, which will change my path variable, and from now on my path variable will contain my git directory. I won't save, however, because I have git already in my path. So git is actually in /user/bin/git, so it's in a subdirectory of one that is in my path variable, so I can just execute it anyway. So this is how you would manually add your git or your conda command there. So now there's one last really interesting thing, and that is that conda or venv or virtualenv or any other Python virtual environment simply does the same as my change conda script. So let's look at it again. My path says the miniconda is not in my path. So if I run which Python, it will tell me the user bin Python. And if I start the interpreter, it will tell me it's my system Python, Python 3.6.5. Okay. And if I now source my script change conda, source, interpret it line by line as if it was typed here. And if I echo my path again, I change my path. If I look at which Python I'm using the one in miniconda. You can see it's programmed by me because there's less too much. If I now run the interpreter, it will tell me it's my Anaconda Python, which is another version, Python 3.6.4. And now what my conda or my venv or virtualenv environment simply does is exactly the same. It prepends a new path to my path variable. So now if I source activate scientific, so this must be a script because I'm sourcing it here, right? And if this here is a script, then this here is simply an argument. Okay, so I simply run it now in my scientific environment. If I now do this stuff again, it prepended the env scientific to my path. So if I run which Python, it would tell me, yeah, you take the one here. And if I now start Python, well, you can't see because it's the same one, but believe me, it's another Python version. If I created a new environment with Python 2.7 and I went Python here, it would be Python 2.7. So we can even see that this here is simply, it's a directory, yes, and if I open it in Dolphin, for which I created a shortcut called D, which doesn't work, I'm sorry. Also, you can simply open it in Dolphin like that. Here, it's simply a folder which contains the binary Python, or the binary like many other binaries. So what simply happens if I activate an environment is I prepend that to the path. So instead, So the system now takes the Python inside that environment as its new Python.